church, I think it would be a good time to come on into the ministry. Why don't you come on out the pew and let's join the heavenly host today. There are angels bowing before his throne right now. Come on, step out of the aisle. Come on down to the front right now. Let's bow before the Lord. push. Push past the veil today. Hallelujah. That's it. Let's just linger. We're going to continue to sing. Let's keep pushing right now. Hallelujah. Church family. Praise is from the heart. Oh, let the fruit of your lips bring forth praise is from the heart right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Worshiping Him for who He is. Worshiping Him for what He has done. Worshiping Him today for what He's doing and going to do in your future. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He holds your future in His hand. Praise God. It doesn't matter what happens tomorrow when you wake up. God's got you right where He wants you to be. You're in the palm of His hand. Oh, yes, that's right. Hallelujah, hallelujah. They're going to sing it again. And let's magnify Him one more time. Our God. Hallelujah. If God be for us, who can stand against us? Come on, that's right. Hallelujah. You serve a moving God. Praise God, an all-powerful, the, not in, the all-powerful, mighty God. Praise God. I'm so thankful to serve that God and to know Him and to know that while we're singing these songs that we're engaging our heart and our mind and knowing that God hears us. Do you believe He's in this house today?
Yeah.
Now listen, if you believe He's in this house today, we say that a lot. But if we really believe He's in this house, then we believe that there is healing right here.
Yes.
Oh, it's here. I mean, you could stretch out your hands. It's around you. You've got to have enough faith to tap into that healing, to draw that virtue if there's a need. Come on. It's just stretch your hands out, up, whatever. Jesus is in the building, church. And where Jesus is, there is healing. We've got some needs we're going to put onto the board, but that's all right. Go ahead and pray for the needs. If you need, come forward and we'll pray the prayer of faith. God is here to heal today. Hallelujah. I thank you for healing today, Lord Jesus. I thank you for your touch. God, we believe you're in this house. I release healing right now. Let the gift of healing be released. Come on, tap into that healing power and let virtue flow. Let your faith connect that He is standing right there next to you. Let Jesus reach out and let Him touch your knee today. Hallelujah. Go ahead and touch the hem of His garment. Touch the hem of His garment and unlock virtue.
Trust in.
Lord, move in this place. Move, oh God, move, oh God. Let your glory fill this place, God. Let your glory fill this place. In the name of Jesus. Close your eyes and sing, peace, peace, wonderful peace, coming down from the Father above. For your peace, oh God, for your peace, your amazing peace, the peace that we cannot understand, God. Do it, Lord, do it, Lord. Jesus, Jesus. God, I pray peace on this congregation, on these people, God, these faithful people that you've called for such an hour as this, that you give them your peace. You give them your strength. You give them your healing and your restoration. Your peace that we cannot understand, that transcends what we know, God. I ask that you give them your peace, your rest in this hour.
Lift your hands and your voice. God of peace. Don't you love it when he comes in like that and just smooth everything over? Well, mamas know, don't they? Ooh, hallelujah. Let's give the Lord thanks right now. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you for the peace that we feel. That peace is life-giving, it's healing, and we thank God for that. Praise God. And I want to tell those that are new here, praise God, I want you to understand that you can have that in your home as well, what you just felt here. When you go to your house, you just call on the Lord, the God of peace, and he'll stand in your home, and he will calm the confusion, he'll stop the fear. If you'll let him do that, if you'll make him the Lord of your home, he'll do that. Praise God. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise today. Oh, hallelujah. Beautiful spirit of worship, you may return to your seats. We're going to move into a season of stewardship. And what a joy to be able to give back to God. Hallelujah. To give back the tithe that is his. And then to add that extra offering of love that says, God, I want to give you a little extra today. Oh, that's right. That's biblical. Tithes and offerings. And we want to give to the Lord today, and we want to bless. And we want to let him know we're not holding on to that because our faith is in him. Praise God. God is our source. And we're thankful for the opportunity to give. Reverend Gray, would you ask the blessing?
Some things you just really can't even put into words. And when the Lord comes in like he does, like that, I'm so thankful for the touch of his hand and the feel of his spirit. Sometimes when you're not sure, God has a way of coming along and just saying, everything's all right. Just take a deep breath and breathe, and it's going to be all right. And I'm thankful for that today. And please do remember, she's at the doctor now. I've been having her time this last week. Praying, hoping. It seems like it's more just a dehydration and sinus thing, and that's what we're believing. I've been in different ones that are out today. The Live and Goods are traveling, and the Englands are out today, and there's a lot of people out today. But I am so glad that I've made it to the house of the Lord, that you made it here today. I wouldn't want to have missed this. I would not want to miss what just happened in the house of God a few minutes ago. That sweet presence of the Lord that just kind of came in and moved like it did. And I'm thankful for that. Just a couple of real quick announcements. We have family prayer tomorrow night at 6. So the men's group that's supposed to sing, if you'll come and get ready while I'm making these announcements. family prayer tomorrow night at 6. Please be here for that if you can. Amen. We need prayer. We need prayer. We need prayer. We cannot have enough prayer. We can't get enough prayer. Amen. We need to be seeking the face of God regularly. Amen. Your personal devotional time, but also collectively as a church family. When we come tomorrow night for church prayer, we'll have some prayer focuses up on the screen. Please look at those and watch those. Those are things that we're saying. Here's why we've gathered on Monday night, is to pray about these things right here. Amen. So if you would come, we're going to ask the Lord to be with us. Men's camping trip is this Thursday, Friday, Saturday morning. Any of you that would like to come out on Thursday, you're welcome to anytime after lunchtime. Amen. The camp will be ready. You can come and be there. Brother Browder has some maps as far as which campsite, where that's at, how to get there. Amen. We're looking forward to that. I know a lot of you don't do tent camping. A lot of you don't do camping. But I know y'all eat. So it won't hurt you to come out and fellowship. And if you can come out and stay late, and if you need it, if you just got to go home and sleep in your own bed, do that. Get up early the next morning, come back out and be with us again. Amen. We want this to be a great time for all of our men. And I think these times are critical and they're important. And it's going to be a good time together. Other than that, I can't think of any pressing announcements that are happening. Y'all, look, today there was a practice scheduled for 3 o'clock. That's been canceled. That practice will not happen today. We'll get that rescheduled. And that'll be a beautiful thing. But these guys look great. They look good. They look awesome. Amen. I feel the Holy Ghost in this house today. Just feel the presence of the Lord in such a great way. Amen. So worship with them as they sing today. In Jesus' name.
Even though I walk,
sorry.
See a light that is coming for the heart that holds.
through the storm. Oh no, he never let go. Every high and every low.
Question certain circumstances and things I could not understand, and in many times and trials weakness blurs my vision, my frustration gets so out of hand. Oh, but it's then that I'm reminded that I've never been forsaken. And I've never had to stand one test alone. And as I look at all the victories, His Spirit rises up in me. And it's through the fire my weakness is made strong.
He never promised that the cross would not give.
Surely perish. Oh, but if I trust the hand of God, He'll
stand to your feet right now and worship him? Come on, let's take a moment and really thank him and magnify him. I found out when the road wasn't easy, he was right there beside me. When the mountain seemed hard to climb, he was right there beside me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I will always believe there's a pattern that the Lord was trying to show us on his way to Calvary that day when he stumbled under the weight of the cross. And they compelled Simon to carry the cross for him. Almost seems like, why? This is God manifest in the flesh. Surely there's some divine reserve of strength that he can pull within himself and carry his own cross. Surely he can do that. It would be Paul some years later that would write, every man ought to bear his own cross. But he also said, bear ye one another's burdens. So here's Jesus stumbling under the cross of his crucifixion. And out of the crowd comes Simon the Cyrenian and picks it up and puts it on his shoulders and carries it only so far, Brother Stewart. Because when they got to the top of the hill, Jesus said, I got to take it back because that's the cross and I got to carry it. I think he's trying to show us there are going to be times in our life when the load is going to be heavy. It's going to weigh us down. And we're going to wonder, can I even put one foot in front of the other? And it's those times that God has designed perfectly to say, I'm going to step in and carry this for you. I've got it. I'm going to bear your burden. I'm going to get you up the hill. I'm going to get you to where you need to go. I was talking to my pastor, Brother Stanton, yesterday. And I cannot imagine, you know, with all that we've got going on here, you know, we've got all the whole nation, the whole world under this COVID deal. Fear has become a governing force. You get a little cough and you wonder. You have a little weak day and you wonder. You get a headache, you ache. And we forget that before all this came, at this time of year, well, we got headaches and we got coughs and we got fevers. It's allergy things, and that happens. But because of all that we're under, we immediately begin to think the worst. We go to the extremes. And I can't imagine all of that to the fact of living on the Gulf Coast. And Brother Stanton said when they evacuated, he went back, said, and he comes back after the first hurricane, and the sanctuary is basically devastated. The roof is ripped off the Family Life Center. And they've been through all that before. He said, so here we are starting over. They get tarp put on the Family Life Center, trying to dry it out, ripped all the sheetrock out, took all the insulation out, had it down to a shell. Supposed to start rebuilding this week, get the roof on it, get the Family Life Center where they can have church. Well, it's going to take a couple years to build a new sanctuary. He said, lo and behold, here comes a second storm right behind it. He said, rips the tarps back off, said, water in the Family Life Center. And it's just waited, you know, just that wait, that wait, that wait. He said, but you know, he said, here's the interesting thing. He said, I got a call yesterday morning. I think he told me about 8 or 8:30 in the morning. He said, man, our crew that had been working on this before this second storm were already there, already getting the water out of the building. He said, Pastor, don't worry about it. It's only going to set us back about 3 days. So we only lost 3 days, 3 to 5 days. Sometimes you feel that weight. You feel like, man, I just can't. And God says, you know what? It's going to be all right. Delays are not denials. And I was really saying all that to say this. I told him, I said, Brother Stan, I'll be honest with you. I've been somewhat in places before, said, y'all may not understand this. I said, I don't have a thing in the world to preach tomorrow. Brother Yarborough, I looked through 66 books of the Bible. I couldn't find nothing to preach today. That'd be like you showing up at a restaurant and the cook saying, I ain't got nothing to feed you today. Like, well, then why are we here? And I was struggling. I said, I'm struggling. I've tried. I've talked to my wife about it. I said, man, I prayed, sought God, read the word,
Tried to just retitle an old message? Change the illustration so you wouldn't recognize it? None of that was working. He finally looked at me on the phone. He said, I'm going to tell you something. He said, everybody's under pressure right now. There's a lot of stress. He said, we're trying to live with it and cope with it, but the honest truth is we are under stress. Anybody felt stressed through this year? I mean, like, good heavens. I sat in our living room last night and said, I just want to feel normal again. But that's been so long, I'm not even sure what normal felt like. Maybe it is, and maybe I am, and I don't even realize it anymore. I don't know. But I know that God's got this, and God knows where we are. And we may stumble, and we may get under the load, but you can rest assured, when Simon picked that cross up, Jesus didn't leave the journey. Jesus didn't walk away. He kept walking right up the hill with Simon right behind him. And that's what he's telling us. When it gets too heavy for you, it's okay to let him carry it. Just don't leave the journey. Just don't get detoured. Let him carry the weight. He's got it. He knows what he's doing. And I know things going on in some of your lives, and I know this week especially, it's been one thing after the other for some of you. Boom, boom, boom. It's crazy. So my message today, now if you want a preached message with a text and a title and 5 points and a close, there's a bunch of them on our Facebook page. Go back and pick out your favorite and listen to it again. Go back and pick out one you didn't like and listen to it. Maybe you like it this time. A bunch of them on there. But here's my message for today. Be not weary in well-doing, for in due season you're going to reap if you faint not. Just hang in there. You may stumble. You may have to put the cross on him a while, but he's got it. Amen? Would you lift your hands and thank him just for that? Thank you, God, that when I stumble, thank you when the burden gets too heavy. Oh, God, you didn't say it was always going to be easy. You didn't say it was going to be easy and light to bear the cross. But I know you're right beside me. And in my weakest moment, you're not going to let me lose out. You're not going to let me lose the journey, God. You're going to pick me up and carry me on. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. God bless you today. Thank you for being in the house of the Lord. I have been touched by the Spirit of the Lord today. I leaned over to my wife and said, I told you could still sing. She never wants to sing. Amen. I'm thankful for her and her walk with God. I tell you, I'm thankful for her love for this church. I see that. I know that. I hear it expressed from her how much she loves this church and loves you people. Amen. I'm thankful for that. Now, she loves her fur babies. But I think she loves us all just a little bit more. So, and I'm thankful for that. But God bless you today. I pray that you have a great week. Amen. And don't be weary. Don't faint. Don't get exhausted. Just remember, God's got it. He's going to handle it. Amen. Greet one another. You're dismissed in the good name of the Lord today. God bless you.